from London and streamed around the world, it's time for Harold Sanditen's Open Mic Party. Please welcome your host, Harold Sanditen.
Though now and then your problems fall within the errant mate department, forget the transatlantic call, don't notify the State Department, for when on foreign shores I am very truly yours, I am. But if inclined to play, I am, dear heart, that's the way I am. When in Spain, for reasons I don't explain, I remain enjoying a brew. Don't deplore my fondness for Fundador. You know how a Fundador can lead to a few. It's just that when in Rome, I do as the Romans do. If per chance, I'm saying farewell to France, and romance steps in from the blur. Cher amour, I beg of you, please endure my taking a brief detour with somebody new. It's just that when in Rome, I do as the Romans do. And if from Italy I lie to you prettily, don't think of me bitterly, you know that I'm true. Except now and then in Rome, in some little tent in Rome, well, pussycat, when in Rome I do as the Romans do. If I write happily, best wishes from Napoli, don't cable me snappily to say that we're through. Cause once again in Rome, in somebody's den in Rome, well, pussycat, when in Rome I do as the Romans, disregard the signs of the omens, when in Rome I do as the Romans do.
Thank you all so much.
Yeah.
Okay, let me just mute everybody and say thank you so much for coming back. It's lovely to be back with all of you. I don't know why I've got Shelley up on my screen. Let's see. Can do that. Can you see me? Can everyone see me? Yeah? Okay. Welcome back, everybody, and welcome to the newcomers. I am delighted that we're back with the open mic on a virtual basis. And tonight we have just an amazing show in store for you. We have the winners of last year's coveted Harold Award for Best Feel-Good Song, Philly Thomas and Diane Horan Hill. We've got Jules Hamilton, who's tuning in from Cornwall. We've got Neil Hart, who's tuning in from London. We've got Linda Pearl, who's tuning in from Colorado. We've got Dom Hartley Harris, who's here from London. We've got Evie Lake from London. We've got Sarah Lee Michaels from Connecticut. We have Sean Patrick Murtaugh from New York City. We have Susan Winter from Florida. We have Jason Graw and Groovy Shelley Goldstein, both from Los Angeles. So listen, since last April, we have hosted over 120 singers on this open mic, which is very exciting. Geographically from Los Angeles all the way to Paris. And we have had in range of age, 14-year-old singer-songwriter up to Broadway legends who have done as many as 14 Broadway shows. Also, I wanted to say that we have decided to launch the autumn season again with no ticket charge. Because I want these shows to be as accessible to everyone as possible. I know there are people who are still having financial difficulties during the pandemic, and I want to make sure that they're able to watch. But if you can afford it, it would be wonderful if you would give a donation of either £3.50 British or $5 US minimum to help keep the music flowing and to spread the costs equally over everybody so that there aren't just a few people making the donations. I also want to keep the music flowing for those people who are sheltering and can't get out to go see live music. The Crazy Cox has reopened, but open mic was never going to be a contender for live performances right now because there's too much commotion, there's too much movement in the room, and there's sharing of microphones, which requires sterilization, and it's just a big mess. Okay, we are going to be going every 2 weeks from now until December 31st. And we have a special Halloween show added on the 29th of October. And I think that's everything you need to know. You'll be able to find out in the chat. The Nazis has put in there. You can make payments to us, and that's fine. So listen, now I want to chat with Michael Ralston so that we can just catch up and see what he's up to. Are you there, Michael?
I am here. Hello.
Hi. So what's where are you?
You're a special guest here as well.
I thought that was a bed. No, that's just the cat's pillow. Yeah, so that's Thomas, for everyone who doesn't know him. I've never met him, but I know a lot about him.
He's the one with the talent.
He's the one with the talent in the family. So what's new with you? Michael's the person who keeps the music flowing seamlessly here. And we love him for that. And he's been with the open mics since the first day that we started doing it.
Yeah, April will be our 8th birthday.
Yes.
Yeah.
So what's the news with you?
I'm very well. We had a great time with my writing partner on Facebook doing a live show, and we've got two shows at Zelle coming up, like in a room with actual people, on the 19th and 20th of this month. And so I'm sort of like, it's my first cabaret gig since mid-April, so I'm excited to do that. And that's the first one. 19th is going to be with Dusty Limits, who I write with, and the second one with Sarah Louise, who I write with, on the 20th. So if you're kicking around in town, we'd love to have you there.
Yes.
And they're doing everything they can to make it safe and relaxing for everybody.
And you and Sarah Louise will be on next week as Ralston and Young.
On the 24th,
two weeks.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's exciting.
It is.
Wonderful. Well, really good to see you, Michael.
And you.
And thank you so much.
Hopefully Thomas will wake up for the show in a minute. You know.
Yeah, I think he will. Yeah. And let's move on to our first singers, which are Philly Thomas, or Wilma Lee Thomas, and Diane Horan Hill.
Take your hand and lead you to the dance floor. As the music dies, something in your eyes calls to mind the silver screen and all its sad goodbyes. I'm never gonna dance again. Guilty feet have got no rhythm, though it's easy to pretend. I know you're not a fool. Should've known better than to cheat a friend. The wasted chance that I've been given. Though I'm never gonna dance again the way I dance with you. Time can never mend the careless whispers of a good friend to the heart of mine. Is kind. There's no comfort in the truth. Pain is all you find. I'm never gonna dance again. Guilty feet has got no rhythm. Though it's easy to pretend. I know you're not a fool. Should've known better than to cheat a friend. The wasted chance that I've been given. Though I'm never gonna dance again the way I dance with you. Seems so loud. I wish that we could lose this crowd. Baby, it's better this way. We'd hurt each other with the things we wanna say. We could have been so good together. We could have had this dance forever. But now, who's gonna dance with me? Please stay. I'm never gonna dance again. Guilty feet have got no rhythm. Though it's easy to pretend. I know you're not a fool. should have known better than to cheat a friend. Wasted chance that I've been given. No, I'm never gonna dance again the way I dance with you.
Oh, that was wonderful. All right, I'm going to find you guys and we're going to chat. There we are. I think you're going to have to, there we go.
There we are.
How are you both? Are you there?
Yes. Yeah. I can hear you. Can you hear me?
Yes, I'm just trying to put this into speaker view. There you go. So, I have a question for you. Did you knock her over on purpose, or was that just a mistake?
On purpose. On purpose. We're supposed to bumps.
Yeah, that was the third take, and at the end of the second take, I thought I'm just really going to give her a big wallop. She went bloody flying, and I loved it.
Oh, that was so much fun. Yeah, I don't get to see you in drag that much, even though you do it all the time. It's great.
Yeah, she's more in demand than I am, unfortunately.
Yeah, I imagine Wilma floats too, doesn't she?
Yes, well, she's natural buoyancy, of course.
So tell me, I mean, you had a gig recently, a live gig at the Cellar Door, didn't you?
Cellar Door Piano Bar on the Strand, which is the old pissoir, that's the word, yeah. The old men's toilets opposite.
Yeah, I know.
It opened 2 weeks ago. I had a gig week last Friday and another gig next Wednesday. So yeah, that's Wilma, of course, not myself. As I say, she's more in demand than me. So.
What about Phil? Does Phil have any gigs coming up?
Nothing at the moment, no. But we're in talks with various venues for next spring, though, more than likely than this year, unfortunately.
Okay. And Diane, what about you? With Heart and Soul or anything?
No. Big Mama is staying at home. But to be honest, my family are taking me to Devon, not next week, the week after. And we actually went out last week, was it?
Did you go and see Julia?
Sunday. We went to see Jesus Christ Superstar.
We did.
The Regent's Park Theatre. And that was absolutely amazing. And I did realise how much I miss going out. But little and often, I'll just start slowly. I can't believe it's actually taken me over the way it has.
It's well, everybody has to react to it differently. I'm sort of in the camp with you. We haven't gone very far. We've been 2 miles from home, no further.
My brother actually in Ireland had it, and he was really ill, and his wife had it, and you would never believe that she even had it. So. And then another friend of ours, his friend died this weekend, just gone. So it's still there. It's, you know, to warn everybody, we have to take it so seriously.
Yeah, well, it seems like it's coming back now, too. I just want everybody to know once again that you two were the winners of the coveted Harold Award last year for Best Feel Good Song. And clearly we know why, because that song was so feel good. You guys are just terrific. So wonderful. So good to see you both. Thank you so much for joining us for the launch. Much love to both of you.
Lovely seeing everyone as well. Thank you.
Thank you. Okay, so now we're going to move on to our next singer, who is Jules Hamilton.
Oh, hi. I just moved in to 14G. So cozy, calm, and peaceful. Heaven's for a mouse like me. We're quiet by the leaseful. Pets are our band, and parties too, and no solicitation. A window seat with garden view. The perfect nook to read a book. I'm lost in my Jane Austen when I hear. Bertinci. A matinee, some can tie to bog the swing and traviata. I'll brew myself a cup of tea, crochet until she's feeny, and that's eight, not a peep, except that clock that's walking. Now I lay me down to sleep, ooh, a comfy bed, rest my head, a stretch,
and I'm almost.
The girl upstairs wakes me unawares, blowing down from 15G, her reveille. She's got like her name is Alagasto and Zacabella.
Zooty boy, boy. Zooty boy, boy.
I'm not one to raise my voice, make a fuss, or speak my mind, but might I query, would you mind if, could you kindly
Jules, let's get you on here. Are you there, my love?
I'm here.
Hi.
I just have to turn the sound back up because I'm in a hotel at the moment.
Oh, yeah, you're in Cornwall. So are you having a nice break?
Yes, it's we left the child with the outlaws. So it's been, well, his parents. So it's been really, really good.
Wonderful. And so what's new with you? I know you've got a new voice teacher. How's that going?
I have. Oh, I'm working with the incredible Gillian Case, who wrote that book we all read when we were at drama school, the actor in his voice or something like that. And she's taken me on. She doesn't take many people on, but she's managed to fix my belt within, I think, 3 minutes. She just did a little tiny tweak, and it now I can get a chest belt up to an E, which is, well, that's the... It's new. It's very, very new.
That's wonderful.
I know. Of course, you can't really hear it well because I only have my little phone to record my videos, but...
Well, that video was great.
The neighbours have heard, and so have half the military base, of course, because I had the windows open because it was so hot with, you know, a dress on and a dressing gown.
Yeah.
All of the base heard me singing.
I wondered when I first saw the video why you had your pearls on, you know? Well, you never take them off.
Darling, no, you know me.
Of course not. A girl never takes her pearls off. And you've got a show that you've been working on too, a Candor and Ebb show, right?
I have, yes. My friend Jenna and I were putting together a two-hander cabaret of all Candor and Ebb songs. And we're not doing any script. We're only using quotes from fabulous women like Tallulah Bankhead for an example. So we're going to use their famous quotes to get into it. So it's all about women with a little chutzpah.
Oh, good. And do you have any dates for that yet, or is it?
No, we did have a possible venue, and then everything kicked off. And now, when we're phoning them back, they can't confirm anything. So we're just going to get it really tickety boo, and then when it's ready to roll, we'll just be able to hit the ground running. I've got the amazing CJ Welsh as our MD, and he's champing at the bit. In fact, he's practically drooling at the moment. He just wants to get on with it. So we're just waiting to see where we can get in whenever all this craziness is gone. But I'm like you guys, I'd rather stay safe, you know, and wait until this is all blown over, because at the end of everything, I think the arts need to come back with a bang. And if we can do it and bring it in with a budget that means we can give affordable tickets, I think that'll help everybody. And we'll make a loss on the actual show. We won't make any money from it, but it will hopefully, if all of you guys, and those are overseas, if
I'll be there.
Come over, you know, yeah, thank you. I'm hoping I can get into the Cox. That would be the perfect place. But we just have to wait and see what's going to happen. But I'll keep you all posted, I promise.
Wonderful. Really good to see you. I'm so glad to have you back.
Oh, and thank you. And wait, you asked me to sing the song, I sing the song.
I ask you to come, you come. I ask you to sing the song, you sing the song.
My Bengali, you know, I just do as I'm told.
Is that true, David?
I'm just glad I decided to wear trousers twice after all. It was this close a decision.
Anyway, loads and loads of love, Jules.
See you soon.
Okay, so now it's time for our next performer, whose name is Neo Hart.
Hello everyone, I'm Neo Hart. For those of you that know me, and even for those of you that don't know me, but can just tell by looking at me, I'm a very spiritual person. And that's what brings me to Victoria Park. If there's not two things I love more than anything else, it's trees and helping people in need. You know what? I think someone over there could use my help.
Hey lady, you lady, cursing at your life. You're a discontented mother and a regimented wife. I've no doubt you dream about the things you'll never do, but I wish someone had a talk to me like I wanna talk to you. Ooh, I've been to Georgia and California and anywhere I could run. I took the hand of a preacher man and we made love in the sun. But I grew out of places and friendly faces because I had to be free. I've been to paradise, but I've never been to me. Please, lady, don't just walk away. 'Cause I have this need to tell you why I'm all alone today. I can see so much of me still living in your eyes. Won't you share the part of a weary heart that has lived a million lies? Ooh, I've been to Nice and the Isles of Greece, where I sip champagne on a yacht. I move like Harlow in a Monte Carlo and showed them what I've got. I've been undressed by kings and I've seen some things that a woman ain't supposed to see. I've been to paradise, but I've never been to me. You know what paradise is? It's a lie. A fantasy we tell about people and places where we'd like them to be. But you know what's true? It's that little baby you're holding in your arms. And it's that man you fought with this morning. The same one you'll make love with tonight. That's true. That's love. Sometimes I've been to crying for unborn children that might have made me complete. But I took the sweet life and never knew I'd be bitter from the sweet. I've spent my life exploring the subtle whoring that costs too much to be free. I've been to paradise. I've been to paradise, but I've never been to. Never been to me. Maybe I'll go next week. I've been to paradise, but I've never been to me. Yes. Where did she go? Where did that bitch go? You know what? The second I saw her, I knew she was beyond help. Maybe in another lifetime I'll be able to help her. But in the meantime, there's plenty more people in this park. Hey lady, you lady, cursing at your life. You're a discontented mother and a regimented
one. Oh gosh.
Hilarious.
That was hilarious. Oh, Neo.
That was funny.
Okay. Where are you? There you are. You there, Neo?
I am indeed. Hi, Harold.
Hello. Hey. How are you? Oh, my God. That was just hilarious.
Thank you, darling.
Yeah, and she was just a random person, yeah?
Cool. It's just like a documentary.
So, whatever made you decide to do that song?
It's really strange. I had that video in mind for years, and then I performed it at the open mic about 2 years
ago. I remember, yeah.
And I just thought, and my friend Sarah's fabulous, and I think over lockdown, I've been looking at a lot of my own shadow, and certainly it was very accurate to me, but also a lot of my friends that are in the, whatever, energy workers, healers, and we've all got this kind of wounded healer archetype. And maybe not quite as bad as in the video, but that fix, the need to fix, I really wanted to play with that because I've been looking at that a lot over lockdown along with a lot of other things. But I just kind of figured we've all got that in us, that quotes do-gooder that does the exact opposite. So it's been, it was fun to make it, but it kind of has that underlying bite to it as well.
Yeah, well, it did make you look very stalkerish. There were quite a few comments in the chat about that.
Very terrifying.
So let's talk about your Fembot Oracle. My God, you finished version 2.
Yes.
It's just amazing. We can't put a picture up. I don't have a picture to put up, so.
I can actually send the file, Harold, like you suggested earlier. I can pop it
up. Okay, you put it into the chat. He has made this amazing group of they're photos, they're moving photos, yeah, I guess? You could explain it better than I can.
Yeah, it's a book I've been working on for 3.5 years, and I finished it yesterday. And it's one of those things, I felt like in a lot of different dimensions, I never finished it, or I didn't even start it. And somehow in this one, I did. And I'm really happy because it was kind of exponentially hard to finish it, just the tiniest last little bit, because it's about putting yourself out there, isn't it? And so it's completed now. It's 78 images. Of me in spontaneous movement that have been layered. And so these oracles have been created. And I know Fiona does a lot of work with the tarot. So it's essentially, it's an oracle deck. So there's 78 of them and can be used by tarot readers. I've got a very good friend who does incredible readings and she's already started using it with people. And it's just very exciting. And I wrote 78 texts to accompany it. And what I've done is I've made it all free as a PDF because I want it in the world. I want people being able to use it as, if you like, a technology. I'm very interested in people deepening their creativity. That's what I've been doing since 2003. And for me, that's all about living more from heart. And so these kind of work like alchemical mirrors just to support you. And you can have it on your phone, you can have it on a computer. It's there for you if you want to kind of have something just to bear witness to. I'm literally going to upload it right after. So you've actually got a copy if you want it. And then you go to the Femba Oracle.
I got my copy today already. The images that he has made are truly stunning. And it's really hard to believe that they're moving images of you. I mean, it's constant movement that you do, yeah, and you layer it. It's just, the colors are vivid. The images are just so beautiful. Anyway, have a look if you have a chance, guys. Check the chat. And anyway, lovely to see you. Thank you for such a fun video.
We'll be back in autumn. Woohoo!
Yeah, woohoo! Lots of love, Steve. Neo, sorry. Neo. All right, lots of love. Okay. All right, let's move on to our next performer, the lovely Linda Pearl.
You went away, I tried to forget you. We broke the ties that bind. I would not regret you. Just leave the past behind. Still, the magic of the night I met you seems to stay forever on my mind. The sky was blue and high above. The moon was new and so was love. This eager heart of mine was singing. And lover, where can you be? You came at last, love had its day. That day has passed, now you've gone so far away. This aching heart of mine was singing. And lover, come back to me. And I remember all the little things we used to do. I'm so lonely. Every road I've walked along with you. No wonder I'm so lonely. The sky was blue, the night was cold. The moon was new, but love is old. And while I'm waiting here, this aching heart is singing. Lover, where can you be? The sky was blue and high above. The moon was new and so was love. The seeking heart of mine was saying, and lover, come back to me. When I remember all the little things we used to do, I'm so lonely. Every road I walked along with you. No wonder I'm so lonely. The sky was blue, the night was cold. The moon was new, but love is old. And while I'm waiting here, this heart of mine is singing. Lover, come back, lover, come back, lover, come back to me. Lover, come back, lover, come back, lover, come back to me. It's like I'm losing my mind. Oh, lover, come back to me.
Okay, Linda, let's have a little chat here. You're going to have to unmute yourself. I can't seem to do it.
I think it's done now.
Oh, you're done. Yeah, there you go. Hello, gorgeous.
Hi, honey. How are you?
I'm good. Gosh, how are you doing?
The dog in the background, you know?
I loved the dog in the background. Was that the one you picked up at the rescue center?
Yes, yeah, my little 90-pound, 2-year-old shepherd. Yeah.
Oh, how wonderful. How really, really wonderful.
Wow. It was,
so
it was,
is that, that's not on your new CD, is it? That song?
No, it's not. No. This was
you
just
have that arranged for this show, it seems like.
Yeah, we did. We're sort of working on a new, you know, a new project. And so one song at a time. And thank you for giving us sort of the boost to kind of have an excuse to try this one out. So Ted Firth did the arrangement.
Ted's going to be on the show. I asked him to come do a piano solo.
Oh, well, you're all in for a treat. Yeah.
I know. It's going to be, it's a while off now. But anyway, I was really excited to
have him
do that.
Yeah, very good.
So how is life in Colorado? You've had fires and winds, the wind has blown off.
We were at 90 degrees, I guess, 2 days ago. Yesterday it snowed 10 inches. we're sitting in winter. It's like we should get the Christmas decorations out. Patrick's ranch in Oregon was evacuated yesterday. Oh. And it's still standing this morning, but, you know, hold a good thought. It's...
So you're not going up to Oregon now, huh?
We are. We're going to leave on Monday, and hopefully, you know, there'll still be a house standing. There's nothing we could do right now, but, you know, sort of chant and light candles and or not light candles. And, you know, anyway.
So you found love in COVID. How do we, that's just wonderful.
Isn't that crazy? Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, long-term acquaintance, and we bumped into each other however many months ago, last fall, and, you know, text, email, very chummy, and but then, thanks to Zoom, we started to Zoom, and it, you know, weekly, and then it turned into nightly for 2 to 3 hours, and then, bless his heart, he jumped in his car in the spring and drove to Colorado because we certainly, no one was going to fly. And that was, and you know, we sort of thought it could be an absolute disaster, but it doesn't matter because now we've reestablished this really lovely friendship, but it wasn't. Anyway, it's one of the stranger, more wonderful things that's happened. And I am very grateful.
Well, it's
Patrick really directed this. That was he holding the camera, and he designed the whole thing.
And him in the photographs, and it was wonderful. I saw him standing behind you just a little while ago too.
Oh yeah. He's on a call now. Yeah.
Now he's off camera.
Yeah. So there.
So
we
what
are.
Else is going on in your world besides losing a house rooftop a few times?
Yeah, we lost a roof. There was the West has so many fires, the ash, for more cheery news, the ash sort of comes and just hovers and turns into these big paper mache balls that then drop out of the sky, the size of tennis balls up to softballs, kid you not. So it's the second time I've lost my roof in a year and a half. And it's like a science fiction. We all just have to keep drawing deep breaths and deal with it. And roofs can be replaced. So, you know, these are solvable problems, even if they're not a lot of fun.
Yeah, they're just, it's just a roof, you know. It sounds like you're playing The Wizard of Oz, kind of. Did the house pick up and you landed on Patrick, or?
not so much. You know.
How wonderful. Well, it's always so good to see you. I love your voice. And
darling, thank you so much.
Sounded beautiful.
Oh, thank you. And the dog, thanks you too, because that was his international.
What's the dog's name? I don't know.
It's just Rex.
Rex.
Big dog, Rex. Yeah, Rex.
Oh, Rex was in the last video too.
That's right. Yes. Yeah.
Well, as dog owners, we have to have our dogs.
Right now, he's not coming in.
How's Lucius?
Lucius is very well. It's my son. He's 25 and he's in LA. Rexy, come here. And he's in LA working from home, of course, you know, for Paramount. He did come and see us for a week, but, you know, he's managing. And I feel for kids his age, but younger too, coming out into the world and just smack into a brick wall. But anyway, we're...
Yeah, well, like you said, we all have to just get on with it. It's just...
That's right.
Not much of a choice, is there?
I have to brag about Harold. He's Godfather Harold because he he gave my son an extraordinary introduction to a big football club owner in Europe, which really was the downbeat of his professional soccer career in Europe. So thank you again, Uncle Harry.
I was glad I could do it. I mean, you know, I like making connections with people and things, and it just worked out. So
sure did. Thank you. Very generous of you. Stayed on it. Until that
not at all a problem. And I really am so happy you keep participating in this. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Oh, darling, thank you for asking me. It's fun, and it's great to see everybody. Oh, my gosh.
Yeah, and Jason's just below you on my screen. Yeah.
It's remarkable, the amount of talent and the community, the connectivity. It's a real service that you're providing. So thank you.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. I really appreciate that.
Dollop. Good.
Thank you. Lots and lots of love, Linda.
You too, darling.
And drive safely and be safe up in Oregon.
All right. Yeah, hold a good thought for the house up there.
Exactly. Much love. I'll see you soon. Okay. All righty. Bye. Okay, now let's go on to our next performer, which is Dom Hartley Harris.
You are nobody until somebody loves you. You're nobody till somebody cares. Yes, you may be king, you may possess the world and its gold. But gold will never buy you happiness when you're growing old. You know the world is the same. You'll never change it. Just as sure as the skies shine above. Yeah, you are nobody until somebody comes and loves you. So find yourself somebody to love. I say the world, it still is the same. You never change. Just as sure as the stars shine above. Good God, baby, you ain't nobody until somebody loves you. So find your somebody. I have got to be that buddy. So go and look above and find yourself somebody to love.
Yo. Thank you very much.
Oh, that was wonderful, Dom. Mm. Let me find you here and unmute you. There you go. There you go.
You got me? You got me.
I got you. Hey, that was just How are you? Stunning.
Thank you so much. I love that song.
Is your baby born yet?
Not yet. Any day. She's due in about 2 weeks. But knowing the girls, apparently, they might come a little bit earlier. So my other half is literally next door. and she's pacing at the moment, thinking, "Come on, get her out of me." So we're watching the clock at the moment.
Good. Well, that, how many will that make? Three or four? I can't keep up. Three.
That will be three. That will be three. Third and last.
Third and last.
For sure.
And you're still really
good. I have two boys.
This conversation before, you're going to get them, drop them out early so you can retire.
Yeah, I'm 28.
You're 28? My God. I'm 20, the age of 28.
28, yeah.
That's unbelievable.
So get them all out. As you said, get them all out and well, all the, they say the hard work is...
You start living
exactly.
And you hit 50.
Well, there we go. There we go. And they'll all be double digits then. So it's all good fun.
And what's happening professionally for you? Anything nowadays?
At the moment, I've just became male vocals in a band back from where I'm originally from, in Birmingham, which is up north. And it's called The Apollo Experience. And we're just, at the moment, we're working on a lot of online digital content. Some of the songs I've done in the shows I've been in the past, a few Carole King things, Steinman, and just like, yeah, music videos, new recordings and things like that, which is, that is exciting. And there'll be some of that coming out really soon.
Great.
And then, of course, I have something in Manchester starting, which I still can't talk about yet.
You know, but I need everyone to keep their eyes peeled. You keep telling me this. I Google your name in Manchester, anything to see what I can find out. And it's not there.
There will be a cast announcement really soon.
Oh, good. Well, I'm very happy.
There'll be a cast announcement really soon.
Yeah. And for those of you...
But yeah, it's live theatre.
Yeah, those of you who don't know, you've starred in Hamilton, in Bat Out of Hell, in Beautiful... What else have you been in?
That's right,
for
yeah.
Those of you who don't know who Dominic is.
Yeah, I was in something called Tiger Bay quite a few years ago in Cardiff, Wales Millennium Centre in Cardiff, which was an amazing show as well. A lot of people from South Africa came over, big, large-scale show. But yeah, of course, as you said, I was in Beautiful as one of the Drifters. That was my first gig. Did a lot of a Bat Out of Hell, bit of Jim Steinman there. And then I've just come out of a Hamilton.
Weren't you in the X Factor too?
A long time ago. Yes, I did X Factor
when I was
15 years old. 15 years old. Yeah, I was the youngest person to be on there ever at the time.
Yeah, well, you deserved it.
And thank you very much. That was a massive, you know, big thing back then. And to be on, yeah, that probably started me off and kind of like getting the confidence to say, yeah, I can give this a go.
Yeah. Well, so, yeah. And what happened the other day when you put a post on Facebook and you used the F word? What was going on?
Oh, wow.
You know,
I think I've seen something. it was the thing, you're talking about X Factor, actually. And it's like this year at the moment. And there was the thing with Britain's Got Talent on the other day, and all these complaints to do with the Black Lives Matter movement. And I just lost it a little bit. Because I was just like, I can't believe, just with everything going on right now, it's just not the year to be complaining about people trying to get a better quality of life than they ever have in the past. And yeah, a lot of denial. You have your phases.
We have so much to process this year. It's almost unbelievable. Absolutely. what we have to process through. It's really, really, really tiring.
Yeah, but we have our days.
Better times will come. They will.
Today is a good day. I'm getting to see all these talented people.
I'm glad to hear that. And soon will be even better when you have your baby girl.
Exactly. We've got her coming along, and I've got a lovely got all the family. And a fantastic show as well. When I can say it to you guys what it is, but it's really spectacular. It's an established show already, and they've done their absolute best. They've been really smart when it comes to the COVID proofing. They've shed their audience in half, and when they announce it, everyone will be really, really looking forward to how they've made this possible, and it's really exciting.
Well, I'm really happy for you, and I can't wait. Please send me a message and tell me what it is.
Absolutely, will do.
You've been
when I'm permitted.
For a long time now. Anyway, it's so great to see you. Thanks for joining
you
us.
You too, my friend.
Thank you so much.
Thank you for having me. Thank you for having me.
Thank you. I'll see you soon again. Take care.
Soon. Lots of love. Bye.
All right. Bye-bye. You too. All right. It's time to move on to our next performer, Miss Evie Lake.
Go down to the woods today, you're sure of a big surprise. If you go down to the woods today, you better go in disguise. For every bear that ever there was will gather there for sudden, because today's the day the teddy bears have their picnic. Every teddy bear who's been good is sure of a treat today. There's lots of marvelous things to eat and wonderful games to play. Beneath the trees where nobody sees, they'll hide and seek as long as they please, cause that's the way the teddy bears have their picnic. Picnic time for teddy bears. The little teddy bears are having a lovely time today. Watch them catch them unawares and see them picnic on their holiday. See them gaily gad about. They love to play and shout. They never have any cares. At 6 o'clock, the leather-clad daddies will take them home to bed, cause they're tired little teddy bears. You're sure of a big surprise. If you go down to the woods today, you better go in disguise. For every bear that ever there was will gather there for certain, because today the day the teddy bears have their picnic. Picnic time for teddy bears. The little teddy bears are having a lovely time today. Watch them catch them unawares and see them picnic on their holiday. They love to play and shout. They never have any cares. At 6 o'clock, the leather-clad daddies will take them home to bed, cause they're tired little teddy bears.
Fantastic.
Fabulous.
Hello, Harold.
Let's find you, Evie. I've just muted everybody, so if you unmute yourself again, that would be helpful. Oh, I'll unmute
you. Can you hear me?
Yes. Hi, sweetheart.
Oh, fabulous. How are you?
How are you, my love?
Oh, I'm very good. How are you?
Good. I'm good. Thank you.
It's been a while.
I know. I love this, how you set the stage. Look at this.
I'll die, of course.
You just know exactly how to arrange everything. You can imagine. Everything.
The minute.
Yeah, you're perfect at all. You've got your tea set there and some lavender and some.
You know, I might need some refreshments to, you know, moisten my lips.
Well, to wash down that cookie.
Yes. Well, you know, I got a little bit hungry in between, so, you know, I couldn't help myself.
What kind of cookie was that? It looked delicious.
Oh, just a plain old digestive. Very old-fashioned.
Yeah. So what's happening with you nowadays?
Oh, well, I mean, you know, just the trials and tribulations of being a glamorous woman, you know. The minutes that go into it for each item.
You know, since I met you, I don't know how long ago that was. We met at Scarf's Bar.
That was now 3 years, 3.5 years ago now, I think.
I have really watched you progress in your persona and your ability to perform. And you really never cease to impress me with your what you do, really. I'm just so taken with you. So I'm so glad you've been able to come to the open mic and we've been able to watch you grow.
It's been a real opportunity for me to, you know, reveal things I've got up my sleeve, or at least I think I've got up my sleeve.
Well, you seem to be one of those people who can do it all. You make all your clothes, you do all your set design. Did you actually sew that teddy?
Oh no, that was an old one that I found. No, I'm sorry, my talent. I have actually bought the patterns for teddy bears. So that might be on the Christmas list to give people. You know, I did stockings last year, and so this year I might do teddy bears if I can be bothered. But it's a little bit more work.
Yeah, it's a lot of work, but you know. Are you working? Speaking of work, do you have any gigs coming up?
Well, you know, I'm already thinking about the cobwebs to lift up for Halloween and the balls for Christmas, so I'm figuring out this whole live medium. You have no idea the drama today. It seems to me that I have to really fight it to get myself on the camera at home.
Oh, well, we're all grappling with that, I tell you.
Yeah.
But here we are.
See each other's lovely faces. You have such a wonderful lineup, Harold. You know,
thank you. And
thank you for having me.
Oh, it's my pleasure. I'm just glad to see you again. And that was so much fun. You always pick beautiful, fun songs.
Thank you, Harold.
Lovely to see you. And hope to see you soon again. Lots of love.
Hope to see you soon as well. Lots of love.
Thank you. Bye. Okay, let's bring on our next performer, who is Sarah Lee Michaels from Connecticut.
Oh.
I don't think that nest is empty. Let me find you here. Are you there, Sarah? Can you unmute? There you go. There you go. Hi.
Oh, my love. How are you?
I haven't seen you in so long. The last time was in New York City.
It's been years.
It's 4 years ago. You came to my show with Anita Gillette at Don't Tell Mama.
Yes.
It's the last time I saw you, and that's 4.5 years ago.
You're crazy, right?
It's unbelievable. So, how are you, my love?
I'm wonderful. I'm, you know, quarantined like everybody in Connecticut. I do want to say, I want to give a shout out. My mom is watching. Her birthday is today. She's on here, and she's 83. So happy birthday, Mom. We love
happy
you.
Happy birthday, Mom.
I know she's not going to have her picture, but she was so excited. So I think my family lives in Virginia, and they're around the table watching. So.
Oh, how amazing. How amazing. Yeah. And so, that arrangement you sang was written by Tex Arnold, right?
It was. So, so Tex is... But he passed a year ago. And so I worked with Tex 7 years on and off. And
yeah,
so
you were working on a show with him.
Right. And we worked, we changed our show so many times. But what the beauty of that was is I would bring in a song and we would have it complete, like, you know, this empty nest that he got from Carol Hall. He picked up the phone and called her and said, can I use this arrangement for Sarah Lee? And there it was. And so, but we were just going to do it as a solo song. And then one day, my daughter and my son, they're now 27 and 25, and they were going to college. And I just said, you know, what I did for love, it has so many meanings because I gave up my career for a while for what I loved, which was my kids. And he said, oh, we got to use that. We got to put that in. So it has so many meanings. And I also, it was the first Broadway show I saw when I came to New York at 19, which was Chorus Line. It was one of the first songs I sang at 19 auditioning in New York. So it has a lot of meaning to me. And actually, later I got to play Sheila. So full circle with that song. So but yeah, Tex, he was quite, I don't know if you guys got to hear at the end, but his signature was, okay, that didn't suck. I said, no, you're right. That didn't. So if you listened, you could hear him say, no, that did not suck.
I didn't hear that. I'm going to go back and listen again. I unmuted everybody too soon. I'm sorry. That was my fault.
But
everybody was clapping over him. So what else is going on with you? Are you gonna ever do your cabaret show?
I actually am putting all the songs that him and I work together, and I'm gonna do a tribute to the many, many arrangements we did. So I'm working on that in my quarantine here, and hopefully gonna talk to Alex. So we're gonna see how we can get that going. I'm also an EP of a theater now, a local theater here. So I've been working on doing a lot of play readings online to keep actors going and engaged. And then I'm still working on that old doctorate degree. So I've got a lot on my plate right now.
Well, you always have. You're always someone who's done so much. It's amazing to me how you can juggle all of those different things and keep it all going. But, you know.
I was doing like 10 things as a kid, and people would go, I've always been that way. I've loved staying busy, but this has really slowed all of us down.
Oh, boy, has it. Boy, has it. Anyway, I look forward to seeing you in person and having a big hug when I'm back in New York City.
What a great show. My honor to be here to see Jason and hey, Jason. Love Jay. Jason, do you remember me carrying your suitcase up the stairs? At that time I was working out all the time. I'm like, I gotta get some exercise. Do you want me to take your suitcase upstairs? And he was like, what? Okay.
Yeah. Well, I didn't want to be rude.
Yeah.
I didn't want to be rude. I had to let you. That was so sweet. You made me feel so vulnerable.
We had such good memories, didn't we?
Oh. We did. Oh. You know, that's 11 years ago now.
Hard to believe.
10 years ago. It's really...
Oh, and I'm still teaching my students online. You know, I've been having a studio for 20 years, so that was such a change to go online from in person, but it's working. You know, I lost about half my students, but still, it's working.
Well, we all, you know, you got to make your way forward, and if you want to do it, you don't have a choice.
And you know, the ones that come back are the ones that want to be there, so that's a good thing.
That, exactly, that's absolutely right. Anyway, so good to see you. Much love. All right, Sarah Lee, Michael, right. Everybody.
Thank you, guys.
Bye. Michael, let's hold off 1 second on the next video. I just want to make another plug. It's the only second time I'm going to do this, but I just want to say, if you're enjoying the show and if you can afford it, please donate a minimum of £3.50 or $5 US so that we can keep the music going and we can keep this global platform of international performers together for as long as we have to do this. Okay, that is our cue now, Michael, to go on to the next singer, who is Sean Patrick Murtaugh.
Más de una vez esta calle vi, pero siempre que crucé para mí fue algo más. Hoy siento al pasar que otro encanto hay. El encanto es que vives tú aquí en el corazón de la gran ciudad. Las alondras cantan y el rosal sus flores da. Un encanto así, ¿quién podrá explicar? El encanto es que vives tú aquí. Amor, deja que suspire de ansiedad por verla salir. Llegó tal vez el instante en que la luz saldrá con ella para mí. No me importa, no, que se fije en mí. Esa gente que curiosa mi alma quiere abrir, todo me da igual, tan solo esperar, ya que sé que tú vives aquí.
You here, and let's have a chat. Are you there, Sean Patrick? Hello, say something. Hello, are you there? You are. Hi.
Okay. Hi. Sorry. For some reason, let's see. I can't really hear you though.
Oh, well, you've turned your video off too, so we just see your name.
Wait.
Oh, there you are.
Oh, there. There we go.
There Hi. We go. Hi.
How are you? Good. I'm wearing pants today.
Well, we couldn't see that. I was wondering, we were waiting to see if you were actually wearing underwear, but
today.
Up.
Yeah, you know, I do these concerts and I say, you know, no cover, no minimum, no pants, which means something completely different in America than it does, I guess, in the UK,
it means
right?
No underpants over here.
Yeah, yeah, no, and nobody tips that well, so I keep those on.
Absolutely.
But, you know, I never have to watch my concert. So now that I'm watching it on yours, I'm like, why the hell are my pants off?
Yeah. Well, there you go. So you have been prolific during lockdown with all your living room concerts. Congratulations on that.
Thank you so much. Thank you. I've been trying just to kind of like, you know, it's a muscle and I'm trying to keep it, you know, as exercised as the rest of them, being creative and creating stuff. If we're on lockdown and venues are closed, you know, then my living room is now my venue and my roommates are my production staff. So,
and are they cool with all that?
I cook and make drinks, so they're wonderful.
You make nachos nonstop. All I see on Facebook is pictures of nachos that you've made.
That's why I have to swing kettlebells so much. That is the only reason I work.
Yeah, nachos can be a little bit fattening.
They can put
on a little bit of girth. So, you said you were applying for Irish citizenship. Did you tell me that?
I've had the application since 2004. And I just realized, you know, now's maybe the time to finish it. Probably get a new one. I qualify for it. I figured maybe now's the time. And not necessarily like I would never abandon my country, regardless of what happens. I think I have to stay here and be part of it. But honestly, if things are going to open up, oh my God, my hair. my hair literally just broke the ponytail holder. If things are opening back up, it's going to be most likely across the pond in Ireland and other places like that. So I figured why not go there and do what performing I can if I'm able to. And it wouldn't hurt to have it.
Well, an Irish passport will give you access to the rest of Europe too, outside the United Kingdom.
Yes,
come here, but you can go to Northern Ireland.
I can, yeah. Yeah.
There's no
maybe I'll find a nice Englishman to marry and then, you know,
and then
just collect all the passports.
Yeah, then you'll have everything. Now, I think you can only have two citizens.
Two at once, yeah.
Yeah, I think so. So you said you're back to work. So where are you working?
I feel so fortunate. I have two jobs now. I've been nannying throughout lockdown. And then my restaurant opened up again. So I'm waiting tables and nannying and producing my own concert. So I guess that's three jobs. So it's interesting. I'm actually nannying right now. And
well, it looks like it. Yeah.
There's a Swedish, a Swedish alphabet right there. The little girl, she loves it today because she gets extra TV time while I'm doing this. So keep the show going.
Even when you're stripped, yeah. So anything else you want to tell us about?
I have a show coming up on September 19th, and it's another living room concert, pants off, while the weather permits. It's going to be kind of a mixed show. It's called Keep Dreaming. And it's going to be roles that I missed out on, roles that I played, and roles that I hope to play. Every show that I do for my living room has a theme. The one that I just did this past weekend was called Back to School, before de Blasio delayed it by 2 weeks. It was very relevant. I sang stuff and university. I even, you know, brushed off German and was singing some Beethoven. Just fun, silly stuff. And then I end it with a cocktail tutorial. So singing and drink
them or
huh?
How to drink them?
I'm for that passport.
you're perfect for that.
Right.
That actually impressed us the most when we went to Dublin is the number of people who were peeing on the streets after the bars closed. I mean, it was phenomenal. It was just so remarkable that it's always stuck with us. How strange. Anyway, that's your people. Anyway, really good to see you. Thanks for joining us again.
Thank you, and thank you so much for having me. And like, what a wonderful lineup. I mean, I know everyone's been saying that, but it's because it's so true. Everyone here has really brought it. And, you know, we've been forced to grow, you know, in our contributions and creating them and being our own producers. So really kudos to you and to everyone here. Thank you so much for doing this.
Well, thank you. You know, I just on saying that, what I've really loved so much about this over the 5-6 months that we've been doing this is to see the creativity that people put together in their videos. And you can have something that is just someone singing a simple song to the camera that is so moving, and then people who do production values that just blow your mind, that you can't even figure out how they did it, and everything in between. And you know, we started doing with them with videos because of the lag on Zoom, but I'm really glad that we've done the videos because it really gives people a chance to express themselves in more than just vocally. It gives you a chance to really get an insight into them and how they do it, and see like your living room and all the wonderful posters you have on your wall, and you know, seeing everybody's home and seeing something about them. I'm loving that aspect of this, and I tell you,
and to keep it clean.
Exactly. The pandemic has been awful, but there's one wonderful silver lining, which is that this show can bring people together from around the world that wouldn't necessarily be here. And I thank you for joining us from New York City. Thank you
so much.
All right. I'll see you soon. Take care. Soon. All right. Bye-bye. And that is our cue to move on to our next singer, Susan Winter from Florida.
This year is the 75th anniversary of the end of World War II. And like many people, my parents were separated for 4 years, and so they wrote a lot of letters to each other. Dear, I thought I'd drop a line. The weather's cool. The folks are I'm in bed each night at 9. P.S. I love you. Yesterday we had some rain, and all in all, I can't complain. Was it dusty? Write to the Browns just as soon as you're able. They came around to call. I burned a hole in the dining room table. Let me think. I guess that's all. Nothing else for me to say, and so I'll close. Oh, I'll wait. Everybody's thinking of you. P.S. Honey, yesterday we were married for 6 weeks. Long time, huh? Gee, I loved every day I spent with you. You know, 6 weeks may not seem like a lot of time to a lot of people, but to me it's a long time, because I keep seeing girls who've been married for longer than we have, but they lived with their husbands only one day.
We're pretty lucky. Nothing else to tell you, dear, except each day feels like a year. Every night I'm dreaming of you. P.S. I love you. I love you. I better get this in the mail.
Beautiful. Love it.
Gorgeous.
Oh, wow.
Gorgeous.
Wow, Susan. That was just
beautiful.
Just beautiful.
Perfect. Beautiful.
Let's chat here. Are you there, my dear?
You may have to,
there you are. Speak up. And
you'll... Hi, Colleen.
Hi.
Hi, world. Oh, my goodness.
Oh, my gosh. It's so good to see you. Oh, my God. That was so moving. What a beautiful rendition. Oh.
You have to understand, my dad is 99 years old and still alive. And, you know, like every once in a while, I sit and go through some of the letters, which I have to be very careful with because they fall apart. And so I'm very careful with them. And I as I was doing this, because you're like, you know, like you kind of made me think, what am I going to do? I sat and I called him and I said, well, what about this, Dad? And what about this, Dad? And, you know, like, thank God, he's like amazing. He still drives, 99, he still drives. Get off the road, everybody. But he was discussing things and he said, gee, this is like a movie because I'm seeing things that I haven't thought about in years. And they are, you know, like he's just incredible because he remembers so much and it was just so wonderful to discuss it with him, you know.
You are so lucky to have that opportunity too and to have the letters. I mean, my God, the idea that you have those. Did anybody save them all those years?
Well, after my mom died, I found this box in the closet. You know, I was helping him clean out the condo. He lived in Florida. He lives in Florida still. And I found this box with these letters that were, each bundle was wrapped in a red ribbon. And it was just the most incredible thing, you know, like to read about your parents at a time before you ever came on the scene, you know, because were there people before you ever appeared? And, you know, like, and right now with this open mic, I feel like the matriarch of this group, but I still have my dad to make me feel young. So it's,
you know. My dad makes me feel old.
I'm the kid. So, you know, that makes me feel good.
Well, you've always been young at heart. You're full of spirit and spunk.
Yeah. I love you so wonderful. Thank you for doing this. And
thank you for joining us. It's always, I love your voice so much. I'm just glad you joined us. And now we get to see your living room and your mirror and the table with the hole in it. And
special, isn't it? It's just wonderful to be in Florida, even though we weren't up north this year. But, you know, like it's been quite an interesting time. It took me 2 months to breathe because the air is so thick.
Yeah. But,
and come to Florida. Come visit us, Harold.
Well, I'm not going anywhere for a while, but I promise I will.
Neither am I. But
all right.
My bubble. So for now. Love you.
Love you to everyone. Lots of love, Susan. Take care of yourself. I'll see you soon. Mwah. Bye-bye.
Bye.
All right, everybody. Now get ready for comedy with Jason Grah, all the way from L.A.
Hello. I'd now like to sing a song for you, Line. Oh. I'd now like to sing a song for you that has been part of my life and repertoire for, over 40 years. I first sang it, of course, a lot of you will remember, when I won the Tulsa chapter of the Elks Talent Show with it. And it was a really really competitive year that year. I beat out a hula dancer from Nathan Hale High School. So I felt pretty good about that. And now I hope you'll enjoy Madeleine by Jacques Brel. In front of the picture show, every night at 10:30, Madeleine, she'll love that so. I'm waiting for Madeleine. We'll go down and eat at Joe's. French fries are from who knows when, but Madeleine, she'll love that so. Madeleine's my Christmas tree. She's America to me. I know that she's too good for me. That's what her mother always says. I'm waiting for Madeleine. We'll go to the picture show. I'll tell her that I love her then. Madeleine, she'll love that so. She is much more than pretty. She is all that you know. She is my whole life to me. I love my Madeleine so, so. I'm waiting for Madeleine, but I'm getting soaking wet. I've been soaked since 10:30. Madeleine is not here yet. I'm waiting for Madeleine. Joe's is close by now, I'll bet. No French fries from who knows when, but Madeleine is not here yet. Madeleine's my shining sea. She's America to me. I know that she's too good for me. That's what her father always says. I'm waiting for Madeleine. We'll go to the picture show. I'll tell her that I'd love her then. Madeleine, she'll love that so. She is much more than pretty. She is all that you know. She is my whole life to me. I love my Madeleine so. I waited for Madeleine. I only have myself to blame. I went and caught a cold again. Madeleine, she never came. I waited for Madeleine. All I did was call her name. Madeleine's my shining sea. She's America to me. It's true that she's too good for me. That's what her brother. I waited for Madeleine. It's always been the same. Waiting here since who knows when. Madeleine, she never came. She is much more than pretty. She is all that you know. She is my life to me. I love my Madeleine so. Everybody, I'm gonna wait for Madeleine in front of the picture show tomorrow night at 10:30. Madeleine, you love that so. I'm gonna wait for Madeleine. We'll go down and eat at Joe's. French fries are from who knows when, but Madeleine, you love that so. Madeleine's my Christmas tree. She's America to me. So what if she's too good for me and her mother? I hated her mother. I hated her so much that the flames, the side of my face, the flames. Oh, I'm gonna wait for Madeleine. We'll go to the picture show. I'll tell her that I love her then. Madeleine, she'll love that song. Oh, oh. Thank you. Thank you so much.
What's that on the floor behind Jason?
Madeleine.
Jason, you cracked me up. Oh my God, you cracked me up. Oops, I forgot to look for you. Where are you here? There you go. Are you there?
Thank you.
Hi. Hello, fellow Oki.
That was my dog's ball that you saw like rolling in the background.
Yeah, Murray, I know.
Murray like kicked the ball. It was so random.
I know. I thought it was a rat the first time I watched it. Those are
it probably is. We are usually, we're usually infested with rats, so it's, that wouldn't surprise me. But in this particular case, it was not a rat.
I kept moving it back to see what it was because I saw this thing go by. I thought it came under the door from outside the first time.
Anyway, so weird.
It's kind of fun when those things happen because, you know, they're not scripted. But then
exactly.
You're so good with improv and everything, so you're just perfect with all of that. So Nathan Hale High School, you mean you beat the hula dancer from Nathan Hale?
Yeah,
I heard so much about that. We grew up in the same town, everybody, just in case you know.
That's right. Fellow Okies. Harold, you are much older than me.
That's true. I am much, much older, but you're grayer than I am.
No way. No, I think I'm older.
No.
I'm prettier, but I'm older.
No, I'm older.
Oh, are you?
Yeah, I turned 64 this year.
Oh, my God. Yeah, you're 10 years older.
You see?
I just look really, I look really bad for my age.
So what's happening? You have a reunion with your Forever Plaid boys.
Yes, you know, we had it. I actually had a job this summer. It's one of the two jobs I've had in the last 6 months. It's been so fantastic. We had our 30th anniversary reunion. We did like a podcast interview kind of thing. 30 years since we opened Forever Plaid off Broadway at Steve McGraw's in 1990. And so David Engel and Larry Rabin and Guy Strowman and Stan Chandler and I did a reunion thing with Stuart Ross, who created it. And it was a ball. We had not been all like in the same, you know, area, same screen in a very, very long time. And we had so much fun. So the Rubicon Theater that Linda Pearl knows and Shelley as well, saw the reunion and they started this drive-in concert series at the Ventura County Fairgrounds. So we did it was on a big concert stage with big jumbo screens behind us. And we did a socially distanced concert version of Forever Plaid. Most of the original cast did it. And it was a ball. Everybody was in their cars. And the only response we got were horns honking and lights flashing. I saw a lot of people's headlights.
Was there any dogging going on?
Was there any what?
Oh, you don't know the word dogging. That's what
no,
you
but it sounds
in the car.
Oh, I hope so. I think probably... Probably there was, because when I sing, people tend to want to have sex. So
that's our segue to Swiffering. You say yeah. You're big into Swiffering.
I had never even knew what a Swiffer was, and now I cannot get enough of Swiffering.
Have you looked up what Swiffering means on the Urban Dictionary?
No, but Shelley Goldstein just wrote that she's having sex right now. This is what happens when I speak and sing.
Yeah, well,
so weird. What?
Swiffer
what
is having it? Sex on a duvet on a hardwood floor.
Shut up.
It cleans the floor like a Swiffer. When you told
I've been
me
doing
you
that
went
for years.
Swiffering, I thought that's what you meant, so I Googled it.
Oh God,
and it
I've
came
been
up
doing
in the Urban
years.
Dictionary.
Hilarious. Oh my God, I did
you
not
know. The actual Swiffer broom thing. That's an American brand. I happen to know this because I buy all this stuff for my dad. He doesn't
is that really?
It, but he has someone who does.
But Harold, that's really what it is? It's
yeah,
having
well,
sex?
You're asking me? I don't know. We have carpeting.
Okay. No, I like the Swiffering. You get those hard to reach places and I do it once a week. So I am totally into the Swiffer. I love it.
Oh, good. Well, good for you. When you come to London, you can Swiffer our house. But you have to bring your Swiffer with you because we can't get them here.
I will bring my Swiffer. I'd be delighted to. I'm good too. I'm actually good. Turns out it's one of my fortes.
Good. And you're taking a writing class, you said.
I am taking a writing class that besides Swiffering is the highlight of my quarantine. I've been taking this writing class for 6 months solid from Claudette Sutherland, who is a fantastic writing teacher. She was the original Smitty in How to Succeed in Business Without Really Trying.
Oh.
And she's incredible. She has an incredible class, and I've been doing it. Faith Prince is in my class, not to drop any names, but we've been doing this now. We write essays, we write short stories, we do aid memoirs. It's been really, really amazing. So it's kept my creative fire burning.
Wonderful. Well, I'm really glad you came back and joined us again. And
thanks for having me.
I'd love to have you back another time. You know, if you're not getting gigs, this is perfect. And I love your videos. They're so much fun.
Harold, I'm so available.
We are. The whole world is. Anyway, really
we're so available.
Really good to see you, fellow Oki.
It's great to see you, Oki. Thanks for doing this. Thanks for having us all. It's been so fun to see everybody here.
Lots and lots of love, Jason. See you
soon.
Thanks, Harold. All right, bye-bye. All right, now before we move on to our next singer, I'm gonna bring Shelley Goldstein on so she and I can have a little chat. Are you there, sweetheart?
Hello, darling.
Hi. Hello, cutie. Hi.
How are you, love?
I just love your hair. I really do. I just love this. It is so groovy, just like you.
Ah, bless your sweet. I'm just singing Oklahoma. I mean, you, Jason Gra, the best man in the world. Well, that too. You know. I used to write gay musicals. You know, my favorite was Stop the Girl I Want to Get Off. Backside Story was one. Of course, Dinner on the Poof was one.
A whole new side of you I never knew. That's hilarious. So tell me about your Chickies benefit.
I have to tell you about this because I am a member. I don't know how I got in this group. This is like, it makes no sense. The greatest female singers, the Chickies. Let me tell you who this is. Eileen Barnett, Michelle Browerman, Nancy Dussault, Julie Garnier, me, Eileen Graf, Donna Meller, Karen Morrow, Valerie Perry, Joan Ryan, and Lisa Vorman. This is a spectacularly phenomenal group of women singers. They're also amazing women. We've all become Chickie sisters. And we're putting on a show. We're putting on a show online for the Actors Fund, of course. Saturday night, October 3rd. I hope you all will check it out. 5 p.m. in LA, 8 p.m. in New York, 1 a.m. in London. It's Saturday night. You'll all be up. And I promise you, everyone's doing a solo. It's called 11 Fabulous Women Sing 11 Fabulous Songs. But we're also doing an opening number. I've rewritten the Telephone Hour for everyone to do. And the closing number, we're doing No One Is Alone, Sondheim. Oh, and it's just going to be, these women are so off the charts.
Will you send me the link?
I will indeed. So we hope everyone will do that.
Yeah.
And then thank you for playing my song, because I don't know if you know, but in about 50 days, we've got an election coming up here in the States.
Yeah.
I'm sure no one's heard about it. It's been very low key. Because everything is great here. We're just partying. We're having a good time. We're Swiffering up and down the Potomac. It's amazing.
I love your video.
Well, yes. Yeah, so I was inspired. Here we go. Here are the girls. And for Joe and Kamala, I took a little number by Lin-Manuel Miranda. And I had my way with the words. And it's on YouTube under my channel. I very much would appreciate it if you would send it to everyone you've ever known, particularly if they can vote in this election.
I agree, sweetheart. We got to vote. Anyway, I look forward to it. But before I go with you, and I just want to tell everybody, this is the last number of the show. And normally we had boogieing and dancing afterwards, but we kind of dropped that. But if you want to stay around and chat with people, the room will stay open and you can catch up with people. And that's what it is. So now it's my absolute pleasure to present to the screen, Groovy Shelley Goldstein.
Won't determine when you walk away. Your views, the amount of the count will not count if it says you will lose. Sure, you'll scream. You famously have a fixation to threaten attacks, but whatever your scheme, the day of the inauguration, you'll have to face facts. You'll be gone, can't ignore. When Bill Barr's disbarred, can't bar the door. While you rant, scream to Fox, they will pack your things and change the locks. Stocks will rise as you crash You'll be out so fast you'll get whiplash. No more constant mayhem. And no longer will the USA survive your private alien. Dum 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 dum. Dum 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 dum. No more plague, they'll be waiting for you at The Hague. No more racist red meat. In the tweets you bleat as you excrete. Ex-commander-in-chief. One last time they'll play Hail to the Queen. And while you decompress, New York State and Andrew Cuomo will be phoning up the IRS. Gong, 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 gong. Gong, 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 everybody. Gong, 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 gong.
Cheers,
y'all. Thank you all so much. Special thanks to Michael Ralston for running the show.
Thank you, Harold.
For participating.
Thank you all so much. Wonderful.
Okay, I'm going to...
Love you, Harold.